This episode is brought to you by CuriosityStream, home to thousands of nonfiction titles from some of the world's best filmmakers, including exclusive originals. Sign up using the link and promo code below to start a one-month trial absolutely free. It's always nice to be able to solve two problems at once. In America in the early 20th century, we had two very serious problems. The first was a meat shortage. The country's population was growing rapidly, with immigrants from all over the world coming over to build their livelihood in booming cities or on what was left of the frontier. With no more land to expand westward and most of the useful cattle grazing land used up, the growing but still modest meat industry was struggling to keep up with demand. The second problem was the explosive proliferation of water hyacinth, an invasive species of plant that was killing fish and clogging waterways across the country. The proposed solution would kill two birds with one stone. Introducing the hippopotamus to American waterways would provide a new source of meat, and the giant herbivores would eat the invasive plants. It seemed like a win-win. In some ways, the plan was clever. If there was no more available grazing land, why not make use of the otherwise useless swamps and bayous America had to offer? Thus, the idea of lake bacon was born. It almost worked. But as we'll see, the plan to bring hippos to America's waterways would have been a disaster. The entire story is really fascinating and honestly deserves its own feature-length movie, preferably starring Nick Cage and Leonardo DiCaprio as the two soldier spies ordered to kill one another but who came together out of a mutual desire to bring amphibious assault cows to America. It sounds truly bizarre, but this all actually happened. Frederick Russell Burnham, the inspiration for Indiana Jones and the Boy Scouts, was a freelance adventurer who would go fight for the British colonialists in Africa, which at the time was seen as a noble pursuit. Besides being a well-respected mercenary, Burnham was called to be an expert witness for the congressional hearing on introducing hippos to America's rivers. A second expert called to contribute was Fritz Duquesne, another gun for hire, descendant of Dutch settlers in Africa, and who fought against the British in the Second Boer War. During this war, Duquesne and Burnham were each assigned to kill the other. The two never met in person until they were brought together to sway public opinion and lobby for hippopotamus imports. As crazy as it sounds today, in 1910, the government was willing to try anything to solve the food crisis. When the plan to turn Americans into hippo ranchers was presented to the public, it received considerable support, most notably from former President Teddy Roosevelt. But the main concern was that hippopotamus might not taste very good. Not that the giant creatures were incredibly dangerous. In fact, Burnham suspected they would be easy to domesticate and would become very docile. Newspaper headlines said things like, "Hippopotamus meat is expected to humble the beef trust," and the New York Times praised the plan for its practicality and timeliness. Here's the thing, it was kind of crazy to believe this was a good idea. Hippos are quite possibly the most dangerous animal on Earth. They can weigh up to 4,000 pounds, more than most cars. They're incredibly aggressive, killing about 500 people every year in Africa. They have a bite force that can crush bones and boat hulls, and their teeth can grow over a foot and a half long. Their skin is a suit of armor. They can reach speeds of 19 miles per hour on land. They kill crocodiles because they can. And baby hippos use crocodiles as chew toys when they're teething. What's more, the crocodiles just let them do it, because otherwise the adult hippos will tear them apart. For most people in the early 1900s, a hippo just sounded like an exotic water cow. They look kind of similar, they're both herbivores, they both provide a lot of meat. What could go wrong? Well, just look at Colombia. In the 1980s, drug kingpin Pablo Escobar imported four hippos for his personal zoo. After Escobar's empire collapsed, the hippos escaped and began to multiply. Today, there are at least 50 of them running amok in portions of Colombia. With no natural predators, these giant beasts are free to do whatever they want. They wander into town, eat whatever they feel like, block traffic, destroy cars. Officials have tried to put them in pens, but they always manage to break out. These are seriously dangerous creatures. They scare just about everything, including lions and rhinoceros. It's hard to imagine early 20th century American hunters would have had much luck taking down these monsters and bringing home the lake bacon. But despite all the risk, we almost made it happen. HR 23261, the Hippo Bill, almost became a reality. In the end, though, hippo meat was just too strange, and it was decided that working to expand usable grassland and raise more animals on existing farms was the better option. This is the mindset that eventually led us to factory farming, a practice widely seen as cruel and inhumane, and that contributes a monumental amount of greenhouse gas emissions. Would diversifying our livestock to include hippos have been the better choice? Maybe, maybe not. But it's a fascinating piece of history, and one that deserves a movie starring Nick Cage and Leo DiCaprio. If you think hippos are as wild and interesting as I do, I highly recommend you check out Hippo Paradise on CuriosityStream. It's a really cool episode, and it features never-before-seen footage of hippos breaching like dolphins. CuriosityStream is the world's first streaming service for people like us, people on a lifelong quest to learn and understand. They've got thousands of documentaries from some of the best filmmakers in the game, and they've got a bunch of material on animals, like Hippo Paradise. They have a huge catalog, including content on science, nature, astronomy, technology, and lifestyle. Unlimited access starts at just $2.99 a month. And as a special offer just for you guys, you can get 1 month absolutely free by following the link below and using the code SECONDTHOUGHT during signup. CuriosityStream is available on all sorts of platforms, including the web app, Roku, Android, Xbox One, smart TVs, iOS, Chromecast, Amazon Fire, Kindle, and Apple TV. So wherever you are, you'll always have access to great, interesting content. Give CuriosityStream a shot and sign up for your 1 month free trial by visiting curiositystream.com/secondthought and using the code SECONDTHOUGHT.